Drawing liquids out of large supply bottles is a daily task in many labs. But do you know the difference between a bottle top dispenser and a bottle top burette? If not, this is the right video for you. Hi, I'm Fred, and in this part of our video series on liquid handling, we're moving from microliters to milliliters and talk about liquid handling tools that are screwed on bottles. The difference between a dispenser and a burette is pretty simple. The dispenser is used to let liquid continuously flow from a bottle, like water running from a faucet. These are used for a wide variety of applications. The burette, on the other hand, is used for titration, which is like a slowly dripping faucet. Titration is a method typically used in chemical analysis. Eppendorf's bottle top dispensers are the Very Spencer 2 and 2X. The Eppendorf top burette is our bottle top burette. Our Very Spencer family is great for dispensing aggressive reagents like acids, bases, and solvents. The top burette is suitable for titration solutions up to a concentration of 1 mole per liter. Let's take a closer look at the Very Spencer. This bottle top dispenser is available in 2 variants, the standard Very Spencer 2 and the Very Spencer 2X. The 2X comes with a recirculation valve to prevent reagent loss when you're ventilating it. Both variants are available in 6 different sizes, 2 dispense volumes between 200 microliters and 100 milliliters. For more information on how to use them and their accessories, please take a look at our other videos at eppendorf.com. In contrast, there are only 2 Eppendorf top burettes, one with a dispensing rate of 2.5 milliliters and another one with a dispensing rate of 5 milliliters. With their telescopic aspiration tube and several thread adapters, these tools can fit almost any bottle size for continuous titration. Let's take a look at how to operate them in 3 steps. Step 1. Attach the dispenser. Adjust the telescopic aspiration tube to the bottle height and insert the top end into the aspiration valve. The lower end of the outer tube is cut at an angle. In this case, it's already done. Step 2. Vent. Turn the discharge valve toggle to the side and remove the control panel. And now slowly turn the dispensing wheel forward until all the air has left the system. And now turn the discharge valve toggle back to the front and turn the dispensing wheel forward until liquid comes out of the discharge tube into the container. Lastly, reattach the control panel and use a lint-free cloth to wipe the discharge tube clean. Step 3. Titrate. Press start to turn on the top burette. The display will either show 0 or the volume of the last titration. The display can be reset to 0 by pressing start again. Dispense the liquid by evenly turning the dispensing wheel forward until you've reached your desired result. After the titration process, turn the discharge valve toggle to the side for venting or press start to start another cycle. The top burette automatically turns off after a few minutes when not in use. When the burette is turned back on, the display shows the last titrated value so that any interrupted titration process can be continued. Isn't that beautiful? One last pro tip. If you accidentally turn the wheels backward, don't worry. They run freely without affecting your dosing. There you have it, dripping made fun. If you like this content, please check out our other videos from this series, and I hope to see you there.